You're watching Bully Badass TV, YouTube's best channel for dog lovers.
My name is Sheena and this is Pepper. Pepper was a rescue. My friend found her and her brother wandering on the street in Echo Park when they were puppies. I happened to be on the phone with her and she said she was trying to figure out what to do with the pit bull puppy, and I said, I'll babysit that dog for you. And now it's 3 years later, Pepper still lives with me. I feed Pepper a prey model raw diet, which is raw meat and bone and some organ. I feed her that because immediately after I had her, with the pink skin and the itching, and it wasn't even hot spots, it was just she would claw up her whole chin, she would bite and lick her paws until they bled, they would get raw, they would get infected. So it took me a lot of vets before I finally arrived to an allergy specialist vet, and that vet prescribed me a science diet food that she said would help the itching. High-grade kibble, if you really read the ingredients, and from all my research, you still find that they're made with a lot of filler and a lot of stuff like bonding stuff, like potatoes, whether it's sweet potato or regular potato or lentils. There's always some sort of veggie in there that's almost always the main ingredient that bonds all the material together. And there's a whole bunch of chemicals added, like phosphates and stuff, that that they put in to simulate sort of a carnivore type of diet. It didn't make sense to me that I was feeding my dog that. And, you know, her skin was so bad, her allergies were so bad. I spent thousands of dollars getting her tested. I figured if we're gonna get down to the heart of it, why even bother to feed her kibble at $100 a bag when it isn't helping? And all the things that are in kibble are the things that I'm told dogs have allergies to. So no matter how high up the food chain I went for high quality kibble, it was still full of fillers and high carb stuff, which isn't really natural for dogs to eat. So I figured I would just do the complete protein diet. I actually asked my vet and she said it's fine. So prep for Pepper's food is not as bad as it was when I first started. I sort of didn't really know what I was doing. And now I've come up with sort of a system. Every night I take some meat, whatever she's gonna eat, and put it in the sink, let it defrost, and my own little system of weight, beef for beef. So today Pepper will be eating a chicken thigh and some pork. I'm gonna be opening this up. So I'm gonna give her that. And we're gonna give her this piece of pork. You feed with the skin on. As you can see, the bones are in. Those are no problem. She just crunches through them. And people say that dogs choking on chicken bones is a real danger. Actually, it's cooked chicken bones because they get brittle and hard and they splinter. She has never had any sort of choking problem. I think we're just gonna give her this. So another thing people say about feeding raw meat is it makes a dog bloodthirsty, which I've heard, and I don't find that to be the case. As you can see, I can just reach in and hold it. She'll just drop it. There's no increased aggression from her. She's not growling at me or anything. So that's never been a problem with her and me. When I do the math for how much I was paying for vets, plus the prescription food, plus all the drugs, you know, the steroids and the antihistamines, and compare it with how much I pay for meat, which I can get pretty cheap, it turns out I'm actually probably saving money because I'm not constantly paying for all of her infections and all of the steroids and everything that goes with that. Like, factually, dogs are carnivores. Their stomach acid is, I think, 4 times more acetic than a human in order to digest raw meat. Their, you know, their whole their whole, like, biological structure is made to ingest meat. That's what they were bred from, you know, wolves who pretty much primarily ate meat. The instances of wolves eating vegetables and stuff is for things, you know, things like when a dog eats grass because they have an upset stomach. That does not necessarily mean that it's an actual necessary dietary supplement. All the research I've done on, you know, raw-fed dogs, they rarely ever get sick. They don't ever really have to go to the vet. There's such a small rate of cancer in raw-fed dogs. A lot of people who have dogs that were on commercial dog foods that got cancer switched them to raw specifically because the health benefits and the boost to the immune system, and the dogs have lived way longer than expected. So I would definitely recommend this diet to anybody with a dog. It doesn't matter if you have a Chihuahua or if you have a Mastiff. You know, they're all the same. They're all dogs. There's meat small enough for a Chihuahua to eat, and there's meat big enough for a Mastiff to eat. They all need the same thing. And she, you know, she's my best friend. She sleeps in my bed with me, but I'm not going to make her eat what I eat just because I eat it. She loves her food, and it's gotten her really healthy. I want her to live as long as possible, so, you know, that's why I switched her over. I'm Sheena. This is Pepper. She is raw fed, and I think for any real dog lover out there, the health benefits and the research shows that it is definitely worth trying a raw fed diet at the least, because it has made a world of difference for her.